Now, I love The Simpsons as much as the next guy who stopped watching after season 8, and a Springfieldian theme park attraction was inevitable. They had already parodied television, film, comic books, and video games from both within those mediums and outside of them, and they've parodied theme parks from the outside, so time to come on in. Although, funny enough, the original pitch for this ride wouldn't have been a direct theme park parody, but a tour of Mr. Burns' nuclear plant driven by Otto. But when Harry Shearer dropped out, leaving 30% of Springfield's residents voiceless, it was time for Plan B. This ride fought an uphill battle with me by replacing one of my favorite things in existence, but damn it, it's like it knew how hurt I was and was trying its hardest to specifically win me back. Tons of theme park inside jokes that are actual jokes and not just bitter jabs. Okay, those are funny. Itchy and Scratchy doing the safety video? That's the most brilliant idea I've ever heard. The ride is a Sideshow Bob episode? Shut up and take my reference to your other show! And they even try to make amends by hilariously explaining in-universe what happened to the old ride, complete with Doc Brown cameo. And they got Christopher Lloyd for it, even though they easily could have just used Dan. And sure, as I mentioned, no new Harry Shearer dialogue. Hell, Phil Hartman's in this ride as much as Harry Shearer is. But the ride is still so jam-packed with character cameos that his absence is minimally felt. And hey, at least Florida still has one ride that takes its passengers to hell. And of course, there are jokes crammed in every possible corner. Originally, the front of the queue was made to look like fake carnival game booths with snarky jokes about the awfulness of carnival games. But now that Amity's demolished, they needed somewhere to put the actual carnival games. But they still kept the snarky jokes about the awfulness of carnival games. Is it hypocritical to take people's money while mocking people for giving you money? I don't know, but it makes me laugh. You know, I've heard defenders of Chester and Hester's Dino-Rama talk about how it's supposed to be a parody of tourist traps, the kind of tacky thing that would be set up near a place famous for dinosaur digs. Like the kind of alien-themed tourist traps that show up at Roswell. The problem with that is, the Imagineers are too good at what they do. And they made it look like an actual tacky tourist trap. They put up cheap rides and then spent extra money to make the surrounding area look and feel cheap, and that just wasn't a goal worthy of a Disney park. If we want cheap rides, they're just a few steps off property. But The Simpsons knows how to parody a tacky tourist trap while still giving us a non-tacky, genuinely entertaining experience. And The Simpsons are rejuvenating this whole corner of the park. Since my last visit, they replaced that International Food and Film Festival that I literally forgot was there every single time I came to the park with the Springfield Fast Food Boulevard. I'm sure the food's not all that different, but look at the atmosphere. Finally, this corner of the park has some honest-to-God theming.